There is a part to mountains, a part to the wilderness. Some people understand that everybody needs to learn at some point, that it's so dangerous. And there's a part of this particular piece of the wilderness, this alpine scenario here, that is so dangerous. You see, this is just a big pile of, big, pretty pile of gravel. And some of that gravel is big enough that when it gets going, it gets wild. We dodged a rock today that was bigger than my head, and we had to move about 6 feet to the right. It was humming. It was making noise. It was a nightmare. And now we've got people behind here. There's a zigzag switchback that happens to like make this slopey piece here work. Well, climbers come down from the top, the very top, and they're really tired. They want to skip the crowds at the saddle and they break trail over here, but every trail guide says not to do that because inevitably you loose rocks down on lovely hikers who don't necessarily understand that this is a murder lane and you got to keep your ears and eyes wide open all the time. So, blessings, it goes to show that when you do get off a mountain unscathed, there is a layer of luck to that. And as well, literacy for these huge outdoor spaces. Yeah, and it's a crowded day on the mountain, and so there's lots going on. Partly that makes it more dangerous, to be honest. And I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because I teach grade six, I'm not sure. But I have enough empathy that when I'm seeing new hikers on a cliffside, I just immediately get weird in my head. I start to worry. I worry for myself. I worry for everybody immediately, even if it's something I've done confidently in the past. But we're hearing people call rock. We had to take note of two rocks today. And that's not cool, but that is part of being out here. So you gotta step kind. It is a temple after all. Check this out. That's why we hang out here.